guys, let's go somewhere today. Where are we going to go? We're going to head out of the building that we miss so much. And let's go to one of my favorite places. I got a lot of favorite places, but there's one very close by and I really miss it. So I think we should go there. Let's see. It's this place. This is the American Museum of Natural History. So this place has been open since 1869. It's now 150 years old. It has a bunch of super cool, awesome, amazing, very well cared for exhibits on life on planet Earth. And this is the exhibit that I want to see today. This is one of my favorite exhibits. It has one of my favorite displays, and it's the Hall of North American Mammals. So where is North America? That's where we live. It looks like this, you know, Jersey's right around here. And we're going to go to see the mammals of North America. There's a bunch of different dioramas in here. People might ask about the mammals in the diorama. They are all real. They're not alive anymore. They've been dead for a really long time, and they've all been preserved so that people can keep revisiting them. This one is the musk ox. It's like a grazing animal, a herbivore. I'm not gonna go into detail about all the animals, but I will go into detail about some of them. So let's wander around. Let's see who's up next. I think I'm gonna look at these guys. And these are goats, mountain goats, but these are caribou. They're like reindeer. And there's a bunch of different kinds. Here's some more grazing animals. These are some sheep. So they're animals from all over North America. Like they could be in Canada or in Mexico, in the United States. And I'm gonna go down this hallway now. This area of the hall has some of the largest displays. And I think now we should talk about the bison. The ones on the left are pronghorn deer. I'm not gonna talk about them too much. I'm gonna talk about the bison. So the American bison, a few decades after the time shown in the diorama, which is the mid 1800s, the bison were almost extinct. They were being hunted for food, for fur, and now we've brought them back. So they're in like much better shape. Let's look at these guys next. They are fighting. So these are the Alaska moose. Moose are grazing animals. They're kind of deer. They get really big. They almost weigh a ton. They can be 1,700 pounds. And they only grow antlers like that if they are boys. And these boys are fighting. Let's see where else we can go. Let's look around here. There's hallways inside the hall. So you can go down and look at different things. These guys are kind of cool. These are beavers, you know about them. They build their houses on the water with little chambers in them. Let's see who else in here is cute. Oh, this one's cute. This is a lynx, and she's very pretty. And she looks like she's hunting something. Hidden in that snow is a white hare, like a snowshoe hare, kind of a rabbit. But you can't see it from this angle. I can't find a way to get to it. Who's here? The gray squirrel. These are the western gray squirrels. I think they look a little furrier than the squirrels that we see around here, but they're super cute. Who else can we see? Oh, this one's pretty cool. So this is the jaguar. And you can see that there's two of them in there, and they're looking over some very beautiful land. I wonder what their ecosystem is. Let's take a look at who's next. I'm gonna look at maybe these bears. Let's see who they are. They are the grizzly bears. Grizzly bears. You never want to get this close to a grizzly bear in real life. The mama will not like it. But here in the museum with these preserved animals, we can go up super close. That's part of the reason why they're preserved, so that scientists can get a really good look at them. They'd never be able to look at them this close. I want to look at the Alaska brown bear. The Alaska brown bear is one of the largest predators that live on land on the whole planet. They can grow to be about almost 800 pounds. And these guys are different than other bears that live in North America because they eat fish, where a lot of other bears in North America, they eat only plants and stuff. Let's see who else is here. I see some grazing animals over there. Let's see who's over here. Oh, I know who I want to see. I want to see that guy right there. That guy right there. Let's make a left. I want to see this cat of many names. So this cat has like a lot of names. It depends on where you are in North America. Some people call him a cougar, but where we live, we call them mountain lions, and they can live around here. Back in the day, these big cats used to live all over the northern United States, but by the 1900s, they had been wiped out in huge areas. Now, because of conservation, they're coming back. Their populations are coming back in different areas, and to the point where in some areas, they're actually causing a problem. That's how healthy their populations have gotten. So let's go back around here, and I want to see, this is another grazing animal. Is this another? Yeah, this is another type of deer that is related to the caribou, like the reindeer. Who else is here? I don't want to talk about these guys. This is a mule deer, right? Let's see. Mule deer. And all of this is done, all this virtual tour is done through Google. So if you're going to do it, you get your parents' permission. I want to talk about the white-tailed deer. And they look like they're right around us, like right outside where we live. And it's because they're right outside where we live. Their populations are doing great because when we do great, they do really great, to the point where their populations are exploding. They love how we clear trees for our houses, because when we have grass, they love to eat our grass. It's easier than looking for leaves from trees. They get very, very plump and healthy eating in a suburban or like almost city environment. Like they like parks and stuff like that. Let's see who else we can find. I'm gonna go back down here. Let me see. See those goats? I see some caribou. I got the muskox again, but I wanna go down this way one more time. It's my favorite exhibit is down here. One of my favorites in the whole museum, but definitely my favorite in this area. I'm gonna go all the way down here. This is where the white-tailed deer was. I'm not gonna go all the way down. I'm gonna turn here. This is the coyote. Coyotes live around here too, but you can see, I wonder if you can guess kind of what sort of ecosystem they're living in here, but they live around us as well. These are animals that if you see them, you go somewhere driving away and you see them, please stay away. So the spotted skunk is getting ready to spray somebody. You see how he's got the back legs up? Yeah, I think that we need to run. Okay, this is my favorite. This is my favorite exhibit in this whole hall, the wolves. They look amazing. I'm gonna confess to you, for a while, they looked really creepy. I got scared. So what's the deal with them? These animals were hunted to a dangerous point. They live in huge family groups. They hunt together. They're ruled over by one dad guy. And I was scared. The lights over time got super weird. And Mr. Guerrero, I said, please lead me past the wolves. And I closed my eyes. I said, take me away. And then he left me right in front of the wolves. Anyway, this is Cottontail in Pumpkin Patch, super cute. Black bear hanging out in a Florida swamp and dealing with, I don't know if you can see it or not, a very angry snake. Super cool. These next guys are amazing. I wanna see if I can get a good angle with the jackrabbit. I'm showing you a snake again. I love the jackrabbit. They have these enormous ears. So if you look, you can guess what kind of ecosystem they live in. Their ears help regulate the temperature in their bodies, because the air can hit the surface of the ear and cool down the blood, so it cools down their body. If you look at these mountain goats, look how they climb. Their balance is amazing. This is the animal that I want to talk about last. These are the Osborne caribou. So there's all different kinds of caribou. And boys and girls in caribou, in Osborne's, grow antlers, and sometimes the girls keep them when the boys lose them, and they protect their babies with the antlers. Pretty cool. So this was the American Museum of Natural History in the Hall of North American Mammals. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you're staying healthy and safe.